are finally in Thailand after 3 years. We've come back because we are actually getting married, and then we're doing a bit of traveling through Chiang Mai. So yeah, exciting stuff. We actually arrived last night, but it was quite late, and all we did was like get a bit of food and kind of just walked around. So today we were hoping to do lots more walking, but turns out there's actually thunderstorms, so we don't know what we're gonna do, so we'll just see where the day takes us. And later on today we're going to see a cabaret show, which, what are you doing? And later we've actually got a cabaret show, so that's gonna be really interesting. So I'm really looking forward to that. So this is the hustle and bustle of Bangkok, non-stop traffic with lots of rain today. So this is Joe's breakfast, which looks amazing. Eggs Benedict. And then I have got a Thai classic, which is pork rice soup. Yum. So we stumbled across this shop, and it's the cutest little shop. And everything is literally like 350 baht, which is less than essentially 10 pounds. Like, look at this. Like, everything is just so cute. So we have found a restaurant that does a sushi train, and each plate obviously is different prices, but the cheapest plate is only 40 baht, which is like a pound per plate. So this is exciting, and you got your own little tea. So this is the damage done. We'll see how much it comes to. So for 19 dishes, it was only 1,188 baht, which works out to about 26 quid, which is actually quite cheap, so definitely worth it. We have just entered the shopping mall Icon Siam, and honestly, this is a sixth floor. It's just madness. This is actually crazy. Wow, this is the viewpoint. You can't really see much because it's quite full of pollution, but you know, you get the gist. So we're now at the food court, which is meant to resemble a floating market, and honestly, this is so cool. So pretty here. This food court is absolutely amazing. I highly recommend coming here. It's at Icon Siam. So much food. So I've got Tom Yam Kung, which is with giant river prawns. They look huge. And Joe's got duck boat noodles. How exciting. Joe and I are on the riverboat on our way to a cabaret show. So tonight did not go to plan at all. We tried to get a riverboat down to where the cabaret show was going to be, and then it ended up not being where we needed to go, and we were literally like, we're going to be running late to the cabaret show. So we're like, you know what, let's just quickly grab a taxi. Get in the taxi, and he's like, where are you going? I was like, with the cabaret. And he's like, oh yeah, yeah, I know there is. I'll just go the long way so there's less traffic. And then he starts driving, and he's just driving for ages. And I'm watching the map as he's going along, and then it's just getting further and further away. And we've literally checked with him 3 times to make sure he knew where he was going. And he was like, yeah, yeah. And then I'm like, okay, dude, you've literally taken us to the opposite side of Bangkok. We are now super late, so there's no point, so can you just drop us off at wherever? So we didn't actually go to the cabaret, so that was a complete disaster. So I'm gonna try and get a refund. And then tomorrow we've got another flight to catch, and we need to leave at 8:30, but the music where we are, because we are at the end of a strip, which we didn't realize when I booked it, because in the reviews no one was complaining about the noise, even though the noise is a big issue. So I don't even know whether we're going to get any sleep.
We would like to inform you that the seats with the red cover from row number 1 to row number...
So we're just doing some shopping, and then we're on our way back to the village to see my family and do some wedding preparations. So we're going to be very busy the next few days. Look at all the rice fields. So I'm forcing Joe to sit in the back with me because I thought it'd be fun. Everybody else is sat at the front, yet Joe and I are sat at the back. But it's fun.
get to see the sun, get the wind in your hair.
So this is what we're having for dinner tonight. Honestly, it's always a feast whenever I come back to my family. Just look at all this.
So I am currently getting ready. It's our second day in the village, and we are just gonna be doing some more wedding preparations. I actually went to try on the dress last night. It didn't look as good as I thought it would, so we've gone for a different dress. So yeah, another busy day.
So for breakfast today we have some catfish and some prawns from last night. Yummy. And then because we are feeling really hungry, my mum also gave us some rice soup. So this is feast.
Joe being antisocial as always. But we're sat in front of my auntie's shop. Just, I guess, shopkeeping, although I'm not really doing anything. And then the weather's so nice today. My favorite things in the world, sour mangoes. Oh. So we're not really doing much, but I'm manning my auntie's shop. Even though when I say manning, I'm just sat here, and then when something happens, we just literally call my auntie over. She's across the road, chilling in a hammock. So she said, if anybody comes, just let me know. So I'm just sat here waiting for customers.
So they are getting ready with all the flowers and the backdrop all ready for tomorrow. All these flowers that need to go up. So it's a lot of work, but I'm not doing anything since leaving it all to them. Look how good it looks already.
So this is the finished product on the outside. It's so pretty, and you can see our names are on there. And then this is the finished product on the inside. So beautiful. And then this is where Joe and I will be sitting for the ceremony. So yeah.
So it is currently 4:30 in the morning. We've literally had a shower, about to go get my hair and makeup done. I'm so tired. It's gonna be a long day.
So Joe, are you nervous?
Yes.
Why?
No idea what's gonna happen. But you can see everyone's already awake, helping, getting ready. People were around here last night as well. So it's a lot of people coming.
So this is my makeup so far. We still need to do the lips, but we're just about to do my hair, but I'm obsessed. I just love the eyebrows and the eyes.
So we are now ready. Ta-da!
And we're just grabbing some food because literally everything's gonna start and we won't actually have time to eat until like 3 hours, 4 hours. So
hello.
Yeah.
Happy birthday,
So the wedding is over and we're now about to have some food, and then we forgot these to actually wear these during the wedding, so we're just kind of wearing them now. So today has been a long day. We actually took a nap earlier on, then went to the market, and now we're just kind of chilling. What I wanted to do to show you this is like my favorite drink. You get it from the markets for like 10 baht a bag, and it's literally just soy milk in a bag, and then you just drink it like this. So good. So today is our last day in the village, but today we're actually doing a lot of things with my cousin and her husband, and at the moment we're just doing some shopping in a supermarket, just walking around whilst my cousin's going to her prenatal hospital appointment. So yeah, let's see what we'll get up to today.
So Joe and I are bored, we're waiting for my cousin, so we're just gonna play on some arcade games now. So for lunch we are having hot pot with my cousin and her husband.
So for my cousin, because she's currently pregnant and is due in July, we've got her some baby clothes. So look how cute this little bib is, and then we have these adorable little shoes. What else? Oh my god, look at these tiny ass socks. Obviously they're having a boy because everything's blue, but so freaking adorable. But basically we got her a whole load of stuff, and then they also brought some milk and things for the baby. So how cute. So we're currently just chilling, the weather's beautiful, I'm in my hammock, Joe's in this nice chair eating biscuits. Ugh, nice and easy life. Wish we could do this all the time. So my cousin's brought us to this grape farm just to buy some grapes and look at what it's like. But this is so cool, I've never actually seen a grape farm. Don't know what to expect, but definitely wasn't this. So we're now picking some grapes. Oh Jesus, Joe, you've literally just dropped all that. You do realize we're not going to be able to eat all these grapes? That's plenty. Look how many you've picked already. We've literally been here like 2 minutes. That's too much, we'll leave it at that. So we've come to this reservoir. I actually remember coming here when I was a very very small child. It just looks so beautiful. So for breakfast, at the beginning I had chicken and rice, but then we've got all these cakes and donuts to finish, so cakes and donuts for breakfast.
Okay.
We are now off to Chiang Mai, let's go!
So we have just arrived in Chiang Mai, and we are currently in our hotel. It's quite late, it's about 6 p.m. No, half 6 p.m. I think. So we're just literally going to go walk around, get some food, and then have a chill night. Ready for a busy day tomorrow. So we have just come to a night market. There's loads of stuff around here. Got paintings, you've got food in the middle, all the little knickknacks. It's quite cute.
So first meal of the night is grilled pork with sticky rice, and we get free entertainment. Don't even actually hear me. Next up we have pad thai kung. These five river prawns for only 300 baht. Like, look how big they are. That's Joe's hand. That's my hand. They're huge. For only 300 baht, which is essentially like 7 quid, which is so cheap.
So, for breakfast today, I have this beautiful French toast. Looks stunning. And then Joe's got a English breakfast, and we are at the nicest cafe. It's so cute. And I don't know, I just love it here.
So, we're on our way to Doi Suthep Temple, and we've got a taxi.
So this is the start of the 309 steps to Doi Suthep Temple. I'm already exhausted and we've only just come up this bit. So we have made it to the top of the temple. Ooh. Oh wow, look how pretty it is.
Honestly, there's so much gold here, it's actually hurting my eyes. But it's so beautiful. So here's the viewpoint, but because of how foggy, cloudy it is, you actually can't see any of the city. Time to walk down the 300 steps, but at least going down is a lot easier than going up. So this is another area of the temple, and there's two giant Buddhas, so we're just gonna go down and have a look. So now we are grabbing a quick bite to eat, having some sausages, and then possibly walking around seeing what else there is. I can't get it in my mouth.
You just record that.
We have made it to a new temple. Unfortunately, it's got scaffolding, so I can't really see it in its full glory, but it's that white, it's actually hurting my eyes. But it's so pretty. So we have made it inside this temple. Literally every temple in Thailand is just so beautiful. Look at all this detail. Wow. Wow, look at all the detail on the ceiling, on the pillars. This is so pretty. For today's lunch, I've got fried rice with prawns, and then Joe's got, what did you get?
Pad
see you. And the portions are huge. Even more temples and gold. Stunning, absolutely stunning. As you can see, this temple still has the original artwork. Isn't that amazing? Wow. So pretty. Literally every temple is so pretty. So we have another big gold statue thing.
Pavilion.
Pavilion, that's the word I was looking for. Thanks, Joe. So shiny. We have made it to another temple. This one is Wat Chadi Lung. I think that's how you pronounce it. I don't know why, but this actually freaks me out. The skeleton saying thank you for donating. That's just so weird. So just donations for buying coffins. But still, so creepy. We have made it. Mad that it's still standing after all these years. So as you can see here, the construction of this temple was created in 1491, but then the earthquake in 1545 kind of basically collapsed it, and it's kind of been kept like that since then, so it's pretty old. We have made it to the wall gate thing, I don't know what you call it. So we've just come across this film crew, and they're filming someone who has got loads of scorpions on him.
Where's that light from?
It's coming from the drone. If it flies too low,
oh my gosh, there's even a drone. So we want to take some photos of the wall, but obviously there's a giant camera crew there. I guess it looks kind of pretty at night with it being lit up.
So today we are doing a we're going to national park, some waterfalls, and some temples, I think, I don't know, some a village, a hill tribe village, so we're going to do that. So we got up at 6:30, so it's a very early busy day, but we're looking forward to it.
So this is where we are at. Absolutely we have made it to the top. Wow. No. Ooh, wow. Honestly, this waterfall is so beautiful. Apparently this is the most beautiful waterfall in Chiang Mai, so I'm glad we've been able to come.
So we are at the highest point in Thailand. That's the replica. And that is the real thing.
So we have made it to this place.
And it's already so beautiful. There's beautiful flowers and gardens. I'm gonna climb up to there to go look at the viewpoint.
We have made it to the viewpoint, but
because it's so, is it fog or is it smoke? You really can't see anything.
So this is the Queen's Pagoda. Might have said that completely wrong, but hers is so much prettier because you've got all the gardens down there and it's purple. And this is the King's Pagoda. His is brown. I mean, his has still got some flowers, but I don't know. I just think the Queen's one's better. So, believe it or not, these are actually cabbages. Can you see? Apparently they're just grown for flowers and not actually like cabbages for eating, but isn't that so cool? So we have made it to the local market. It's literally just like a side of the road. There's like seats, so you just kind of like pick what you want. There's food stores on both sides. Honestly, I'm so looking forward to eating. I'm so hungry. So we are finally trying out the traditional Chiang Mai dish, the popular dish called khao suay, and this is with chicken. So let's see how it goes. Okay, I can see why this dish is famous, because it's actually really, really good. And the chicken just falls apart because it's been stewed for ages. We're sharing a bowl so we can basically eat more food, but honestly, I highly recommend.
Next up, we have khao khao mu, which is basically stewed pork leg with egg and spicy sauce. And honestly, the last dish and this dish is only 50 baht, so cheap.
So today is going to be a really exciting day because we're going to the elephant rescue park, where we're going to be spending half the day with elephants. So that is really exciting. We've had another early start. We woke up at 6:30 and now we're waiting to get picked up, so I can't wait.
Okay, now we walk up.
So this elephant rescue park is honestly so good. Like, you literally just walk around with the elephants and then we just follow them around. Like, you're not forcing them to do anything. Like, we're literally just stood here watching the elephants come. Like, isn't this cool? Look how cute they are. There's two coming up and then there's a little baby one behind. Look at them scratching. So these are the two females. They're about 45 years old. And then we have Sunday, who is only 7 years old, and he's the only male at this rescue park. You can tell they're males by their little tusks. The elephants are now going to have a bath. Look at them. So cute. Look at him. Enjoying the mud. Yeah, he gets... Oh wow, I just felt... Oh! So we've just got back from the elephant sanctuary and we're now making the use of our swimming pool at the hotel. It's like a really nice day in a really nice area. There's just Joe bobbing up and down. It's a really shallow pool, so he could literally just, yeah. It's literally like not even up to his waist. So we are off to the shopping centre. And we thought, instead of walking, because it's ridiculously hot, we'd actually get a tuk-tuk, just enjoy the cool breeze. So, Joe and I are or you can eat Korean buffet, and this is only the first round. I don't know how we're gonna eat all this, but let's give it a go.
I thought I'd kind of like wrap up the whole elephant experience. So we went to Elephant Rescue Park. I highly recommend them because they genuinely care about the elephants and just let the elephants kind of roam around. You walk with the elephants, you don't just stand there, feed them and pet them. Like, you literally just walk with them whilst they're doing like their daily routine. So they walk up to the mountains, eating as they go along, and then they go for into the little bathing area, and they literally just splash around. And yeah, you can touch them, you can feed them, and you can, like, you know, kind of like brush them, but it's all like what the elephants want to do, and that they're not forcing them to do this. And another thing is, I don't know if this is like common knowledge, but the tour guide basically told us that a lot of elephants in these sanctuary rescue parks, they're actually not rescued. They actually rent out these elephants just for their park to get tourists come in. And apparently you can rent an elephant for like 2 million baht, depending on like how healthy, how old or how young they are, which I find absolutely crazy. The fact that these parks and sanctuaries are advertising them as, oh, we've rescued these elephants and we're taking care of them. And don't get me wrong, I'm sure they are being taken care of, but it's the fact that they are renting them. Whereas Elephant Rescue Park, they actually have bought the elephants themselves to keep at their parks, to take care of them. So you can tell that they really do care about their elephants. And the tour guide was saying that the owner, he will literally take out loans just so he can rescue more and more elephants, which I find absolutely crazy. But overall, highly recommend it. And if you don't end up going to Elephant Rescue Park and end up going, I don't know, to other places, just do your research. I highly recommend researching, reading the reviews, just to see what it's like, because even though some places advertise as sanctuaries and rescue parks, it might not be as legit as you think, because a lot of it is annoyingly like tourist traps. But I highly recommend it, because it was such a beautiful day, such a beautiful experience, one that I'll never forget, especially because there was a bit where we're in the little bathing area, and one of the elephants, Sunday, his name, he's a 7-year-old elephant, he was just lying down on his side, and we were like bathing him, splashing him. And then Joe, he was literally at the end, as in like by his butt, and the elephant just starts having a poo, and the poo just literally floats right next up to Joe. And honestly, it was hilarious. So yeah, it was a really, really good day. I highly recommend it for anyone.
So I'm just enjoying my coconut whilst watching a Muay Thai fight. Honestly, it's like, you can really hear the sound of them when they kick each other. It's quite intense. Oh. Oh.
Ah. So we are back in Bangkok for a couple of days before we fly back to London. So at the moment we're just at a Japanese restaurant, about to order a load of food again. And we are going to see a cabaret show tonight, so that's going to be exciting.
So this is my main. Look how pretty it is. It's just ridiculously big. And we've also got a sushi set, and we've just finished gyoza, so gonna be another big evening of eating.
So we've made it to the right boat this time, to the cabaret, so I'm looking forward to that. It's so nice on this boat, it's got a nice breeze.
So we are at the Eclipse Cabaret, and look how cute this seating area is. This is so nice.
We have decided to visit the Sea Life Center, and look at how big these fishes are. Like, you can see the child is there, there's an adult there, and these are the fishes in comparison to them. So big. Look at that one over there. That's how big they are. Whoa, look at that. What's this one called again?
Swordfish.
Wow. So pretty.
So we're just sat here watching all the fishies and sharks. It's quite peaceful. The sun is setting and it's so pretty. This bar is so nice.
So this is my cocktail. It's mango sticky rice and it's literally the cutest cocktail I've ever seen in my life.
And we have some prawns. So this is our dinner for tonight, our last night in Bangkok. So it looks good.
So it's the end of our holiday and we're both incredibly sad and depressed. We're literally about to board our flight. And yeah, it's a long ass flight, 13 hours back to London. But it was fun. Did you have fun? Wow, enthusiastic. So yeah.